Really should have thought to set this up beforehand.
I forgot.
All saved. Game. Before starting,
what you were doing?
I forgot to set up the PC games scene to be showing Stellaris and my camera.
Gotcha.
So that's what it was just empty. But welcome. I'm go ahead and start working on this new setting, this new empire in Stellaris. I really enjoy Stellaris. It's not an action-packed game, so my wife isn't giving me crap about it, but that's okay. I like it. It's nice and chill, and I enjoy that. At least, yeah, most of the DLCs. There are a few missing. I don't have Nemesis. I don't have Humanoid Species Pack, Lithoid Species Pack, Necroid Species Pack, or Aquatics Species Pack. So, we'll be doing any of those, obviously, tonight. I do want to pick them up eventually. I keep using my personal spending account for other things. Like, just got set up to be at Paracon. Last year I was at Paracon selling tickets, or selling copies of Tall Tales Volume 1. I didn't have Volume 2 ready yet at that time, but Volume 1 was there, and I was finalizing Volume 2 at the time. I'm gonna have Volume 2, Volumes 1 and 2 there this year. So very excited for that. It was a great show. Last year was the first year of it. But I just paid for a table, so we're going to be there again this year, which will be in June? I should have checked that before I started talking about it. June or July? It's around there somewhere. I'll find it. Let's see here. showing that camera? That, you know what, I might not be showing. No, I am definitely showing that calendar. I know I put it on the calendar. Huh, not showing. I'll find it later. Anyway, it's June or July. Paracon. You look up PARACONN. And, it should be there. You check it out. Anyway, let's get into Solaris. I'm calling this the Enrelisha Chronicles. I'm going to build an empire called Enrelisha. That is, look at all these other. See, this is just me now, where they show all the ones that you can't access because you don't have the DLC. It's like, oh, you could be this dwarf-looking guy if you bought the Humanoids DLC pack. And it's also just like, you know, clearly you have them there. Like, all species are in this game really is art. And there's the art. Like, I'm just paying you to remove this border. It says I can't use them.
There's more than just art involved, I'm sure.
Huh?
There's more than just art involved, I'm sure. It's probably like backstory or something.
Well, there's a little bit, yeah. Oh, crap. Hold on a second.
What did you do?
I didn't close the thing. Sorry, just almost burning the house down. No. Our house is heated with a wood stove, so I'm doing this very sci-fi video game while heating my house with a wood stove. And but it's.
You forgot you had a wood stove.
So, I, there's a thing you open in the front to let enough air in that it will, like, ignite and start working properly. And then you close it when it's ready to, like, just start heating the house. I didn't light it most of the day because it was warm enough if I didn't need to, but I just lit it before I came in here. And then I forgot that I just lit it, and so I still had the thing open. And then I started smelling smoke.
Yep.
And I was like, oh, I gotta go. So I didn't run into deal with that.
Yep. Only just almost burning
down. Not the house wouldn't have burned down. The house
was charred, is all.
The house would have been fine. There was no fire coming out. We might have been slightly less than fine. But the house would have been fine.
Oh.
The house doesn't breathe. What type of species do I want to get? So, the Enrelisha, this is a name that I've used before. I don't know if I've used it in Solaris, but I've definitely used it before. It's from a webcomic that I used to write called Fatebound, which was kind of a weird and complex story. And a big part of why I was doing it when I was preparing to write Tall Tales, and I needed to practice some elements of my storytelling. And so I did that for a while. I ended up having to set aside because of time conflicts, and by the time I was ready to really explore getting back to it, I was ready to do Tall Tales, and so I've just kind of set it aside indefinitely. I may or may not pick it up at some point. I may actually turn it into what I probably should do, honestly. Like, I enjoy doing it as a webcomic, but I think it would fare better. I think it would benefit a lot from just being written, and maybe I'll do that as a web serial at some point, convert it over to that. Because it was already written, and then I was converting it to webcomic. Like, the Epic of Withdrawal was a story arc in it, and I originally wrote the Epic of Withdrawal as a Homeric epic, with a bunch of footnotes from different translators arguing about how to translate it and everything. And then I kind of moved it to a new world and changed some elements of it. and then made a webcomic. But in the process of making a webcomic, it lost a lot of the feel of the Homeric epic. I wouldn't mind going back and changing that, making it an epic poem again, with some of the changes that I've made to it since then. So maybe that'll become a web serial at some point. I think it would need to be a serial of some sort. I don't think it would work necessarily as, you know, traditionally published books. I'm open to being convinced otherwise, but I just am not at this time convinced of that. I actually kind of really like this guy. That's a cool looking alien. It's a very alien looking alien. I dig it. Man, that's gonna be the end of the indeterminable gender. I think I might do that actually. She has pores. Okay. Extremely adept. So let me see here. Phototropic, what was this? These are new. Yeah, some of these are new. Some of these didn't exist before. That's what I played. That's nifty. I like both of these. Let me get this one. There. Sasha's so dead. Okay, that bought me some space though. I like conservation is super handy. Adaptive, yeah, there we go. Japan in the book calling Japan was a city. It was the capital of the country called Indonesia. In older stories, it was called Jekland, and then eventually it became Jektown. It got augmented over time. So maybe made that their home world. And this was the name of their son. That really didn't sun god show us. Let's see here. Tropical world. City appearance. Always is pretty cool looking. The anthropoid city is really cool looking. Let's Google lead. Yeah, maybe that. Okay. Consider doing this one. I like this one. What's this? Oh, clicks. Jimmy's first is on a purple dragon. Oh. We'll do that one. Okay, let's see here. I like the democratic system that they have in this game, but I don't like having to deal with the election every 10 years because of how fast you go through 10 years. Where was this?
I may be an artificial intelligence, but I share your enthusiasm for seeking out fellow organic intelligences among the stars.
You seem overworked. Have you considered joining a union?
I like that one. To do like this because it makes it a lot more tolerable for me on the map being colorblind. Just some of the colors don't work for me at all. Thank you. Oh, alright. Sure, why not? Doesn't have hair, then I thought it was okay. Just the vibe here. Okay. So this is what we're doing. Oh, I can hide unknown content. Ah, I just opened it all the way through before I found that. Dang it. Okay. Save that. Okay, let's do this. Yeah, big, huge, stick huge. Empires. Do that. Advanced AI starts in like one. Fallen Empires. Doesn't like that one. One of those. Marauder Empires. I don't like that. I love finding early civilizations. Increase that. Okay. I don't think I've ever actually done Iron Man mode. That's the only three achievements. And it means that you cannot save at all. I mean, you save, like, get saves periodically or whatever. You can't go back to previous saves. So there's no, like, testing the waters on a war and then backing, saving, going to a save before the war started. It is not working out for you. Ooh. Here, do it. Let's try it. Unleash Your Chronicles is going to be Iron Man mode. We're going to get accomplishments. We're going to try this out.
We will stand as one in the face of our enemies.
Who is seeing alien civilizations? Spend your way to being conservative. We'll let you. Dig it. Oh, hey, this is new. It's been a little, I don't know how new it actually is, but it's definitely been months since I've touched Stellaris. So it's new to me. So first of all, let's set up our, scientists, something to do. Winter's Rift, good place to start for that. Afterburners. Great Sergal Commonwealth and the Imperium of Glogosh. That's cool looking.
Initiating communications.
Make this happen. Set up fantasies.
Initiating communications. Initiating communications. Okay, so what we got here? We got commercial zones, we got research lab, we got ministry of office, we got planetary things. Okay, nice. I'm gonna need a... An alien empire is making contact. Anomaly detected. Construction complete.
Cool. There's some point during the previous 1,000 years.
This is our homeworld and the capital of our empire.
Okay.
Nice. Remarkable. We have.
Cool. Large mineral rich asteroid collided with Tatanga 3 at some point during the previous 1,000 years in what must have been a major impact event. An abundance of minerals can now be found on the planet in the vicinity of the impact crater. No voice.
Survey complete.
Oh, they're there. Okay. Hey.
Construction complete.
Ooh. Sweet. Where's that?
Construction complete.
They took it. Dang.
Log updated.
Okay, so let's see here. We'll speed this up in a little bit. Probably should be speeding it up now, honestly. Oh. Where does that?
Anomaly detected.
Massive crater on tile 3 appears to be the result of a collision with a starship. From the size of the crater, we suspect that a ship exiting a hyperlane at maximum velocity rammed the planet for reasons unknown roughly 10,000 years ago. The FP Clegg Lorsch has picked up residual subspace echoes near the crash site, reminiscent of a collapsed hyper particulate field, but as the ship itself disintegrated on impact, the theory cannot be verified. We're going to pick up, Discovery. Here we go ahead and find a new planet. What are we going on our science? Potato's done. Okay.
Construction complete. Anomaly detected.
I need to build another ship that can easily put that type of thing. Nice.
Survey complete. One to be doing archaeology and the other one to be following up on anomalies. Construction complete. Survey complete.
Scientist.
Construction complete. Anomaly detected. Anomaly detected.
Yes. Finally, kind of fellow wanderers among the stars. Spectre tends to be unknown, potentially even hostile. The atmosphere drifted, following the report from our Monday fleet, can best be described as rapturous. Okay, I'll just send somebody to do that. Let's do this real quick. And, Dibber Dabber. You take care of that.
Survey complete. Technology discovered.
Software trading company. Yeah, maybe that's not to date on it, but no, I don't know.
Construction complete.
No, there's nothing of valuable there. Okay. Cool. I don't influence always. Yeah, I can do this.
Survey complete.
Codifying languages by the Delta aliens. Unfortunately, what they had taken to their language Christian was not a language. In the report, envoy Dibber Dabber states that
technology discovered.
Investigating.
Log updated.
Okay.
Construction complete.
Construction ship. Okay, I'm also gonna pause this. But yeah, construction ship in orbit. Go to it. Oh, good.
Technology discovered. Special project complete.
Nice. While you're there, go to another research station. Then, here, go to more research stations. We've managed to pick up a clear audio feed of conversations between several Delta aliens. Just while the aliens are still none the wiser as to the meanings of any of the words here. According, they are optimistic that this new signal will help them make significant progress for the breakthrough. Good deal. Okay, light show. Science officer Gloomy reports that the luminous waves coursing through the ice that blankets Vatican 7 or 8 are of alien origin. some ancient battle deposits scattered wreckage from an alien fighter on the probe planet. Only the exposed core of its main weapon remains intact. Seems to be the race to use lasers, somewhat more advanced than the one currently used by the Inhalation fleets. The physical energy periodically discharge low-powered lasers into the ice of Bioplanate. The planet's harsh climate prevents the lasers from actually melting the ice, allowing the chilling matrix to act as a brilliant prism.
Technology discovered.
Nice. I did pull that off. Okay. Research all the anomalies a bit. Very part of the formation lies an overgrown processional entrance leading deep underground, choked with vegetation and half buried in rubble from some tectonic shift ages past. The going is very hard, and cleaning the passageway will be quite an undertaking. Alright, get to it, I guess. Emerges as unidentified. Group aboard the SP Gleg Urodash report that the Vatican shipwreck appears to have been the result of an unexpected geomagnetic solar storm. Supply ship suffered a complete loss of life support systems and sustained inoperable damage, drifting into an interbody comes gravity well. There are no survivors. The ship's cargo hold does indeed contain a notable amount of minerals. However, the captain of the SP Clay Uridosh cautions that the construction indicates Surgog design. Cites that the minerals belong to the Great Surgog Commonwealth, and they may be displeased to relate them to the shipment. Now, give it back.
Construction complete. Anomaly detected. Log updated.
Let's see where it does. Our pleasure, yeah.
Survey complete. Continues to invite speculation. Design is completely unfamiliar to us, suggesting that we might be dealing with a new alien civilization and a possible first contact scenario. So, in fact, the alien space has clear capable of space travel. We know next to nothing about these fuzzy beings. No effort should be spared to find out more. Alright. That's the same one. Okay. The long photo remains of a single individual locked to a previously unknown mammalian species that have been found drifting in high orbit over Evanar 5. The being is dressed in what appears to be a flight suit complete with a helmet and maybe a fighter pilot that drifted in some ancient battle only to be forgotten and left behind. Our study of the corpse has provided some interesting data. That is a tragic fate. Construction complete.
Hey, I'm talking to these people. Greetings from the Confederacy of Giants, a diplomatic nation committed to upholding the individual freedoms of our citizens regardless of their species. Our elected leader, President Kukru Kukongi, hopes for a long and fruitful relationship with her people. Yeah, we salute you. Oh,
that initiating communications.
Yeah, let's do that.
Initiating communications.
Absolutely. Remember puzzle box. Once past the collapsed entrance, a tunnel bores deep into the earth, architecturally flawless despite its age. Kilometers down it opens into a massive, perfectly spherical chamber. Floating in suspension at the very center is an inscrutable alien device, a semi-opaque, ever-tinted cube of intricate alien patterns inscribed on all six sides. Touching the inscriptions causes rhythmic pulses of light via emitted from the cube. There's no trace of any known language code or mathematical equation in the chamber or on the puzzle box itself, but it's merely just assumed the box is a riddle of some kind. Alright, yeah, see what you can do about that. Magnetic reversal. Magnetic field of Phion 6A, which is the moon, experienced a complete reversal while it was being observed by the SP Plague Urdash. This rare event has interchanged the positions of the moon's magnetic poles. Unfortunately, it was all recorded by the sensors of our ship, providing our scientists with a lot of valuable data. Sweet.
Initiating communications.
Yeah, what's up?
Construction complete.
Sure. Okay, so aliens, we have that. Cool. Now you can get started or whatever. You can get
started. Survey complete. Initiating communications. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Initiating communications.
Can we just invite them to become part of the...
Technology discovered. Construction complete. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Survey complete. Survey complete.
Hmm. Ooh, okay. That's noisy. Alright. Solving the puzzle box turned out to be quite an ordeal. Aligning the patterns themselves was not enough. They also had to be solved in a particular order, with the calculations of each step altering those of all subsequent ones in nearly endless permutations. There was much time consuming backtracking, but in the end it was unlocked. As the last pattern clicked into place, the puzzle box exploded into millions of tiny points of light. The lights danced madly in the air for a few moments before coalescing to create words in some unknown language. Oddly, all witnesses to this event seemed to instinctively understand the message without knowing the words. For a few seconds before flickering out forever, it read, "You have passed the trial. We shall respond accordingly." Let's hope the night goes well for us. Alright. That's cool. Did I get a structure here?
Anomaly detected. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Survey complete. Anomaly detected.
Two additional mining districts.
Anomaly detected. Survey complete.
Nice.
Technology discovered. Technology discovered. Thank you. Construction complete. Technology discovered. Survey complete. Construction complete.
We have such a good thing going on.
The presence of the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed.
Awesome.
Ships upgraded. Construction complete.
That's all right. Okay.
Survey complete. Log updated. Special project complete. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed.
Hey.
Construction complete. Anomaly detected.
Mm-hmm.
Survey complete.
Okay.
Survey complete. Construction complete.
Okay.
Technology discovered.
Yes.
Survey complete. Construction complete.
There's still a new life form on Clendath, although calling it a life form may be incorrect. NPCs are fully automated mechanical drones, but exclusively for some unknown industrial purpose. Observation will continue, but since it's unlikely these machines are programmed with defense protocols, it would be prudent. Since it's likely that these machines are programmed with defensive protocols, it would be prudent to tread lightly. Okay. Do so, then. What do I got in here?
Survey complete. Technology discovered. Anomaly detected. Technology discovered.
Okay.
Construction complete. Thank you.
SB Clyde Lore Screw report that what first appeared to our parents as an asteroid is in fact a gigantic floating ball of junk. Comprised of the broken remains of various vehicles, rockets, and hazardous materials, many of them radioactive, the junk ball seems to be the detritus of an unknown alien nation in the early space age. It appears this nation was an interstellar litterer, rejecting dangerous industrial waste in orbit rather than disposing of it planet side. Radiometric dating suggests that these remains are millions of years old and have been floating through space from an unknown point of origin for most of that time. Science officer Balog notes that some of the materials found in this floating junk heap are quite rare, could be refined into useful resources. Sure. Why not? Keep at it. Yeah.
Survey complete. Anomaly detected. An alien empire is making contact. Survey complete. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Anomaly detected. Survey complete.
Most of the asteroid has been laser chiseled with great precision into the likeness of a small and relation temple or large shrine. A shrine to the untold, the great destroyer deity of old and relation faiths. The temple has been tumbling through the quiet of space for far longer than we have been capable of spaceflight, which is disturbing at best, terrifying at worst. Naturally, science officer Glabber urges us to search for more stellar objects that match the characteristics of the space temple. Has uploaded a list of likely candidates and nearby systems to the situation log.
Long
Let's do
update.
That.
Construction complete. Log updated.
The SP Ertl Glenn has entered the Jurassic system, and its crew report that solar object not unlike the Shrine of the Untold is indeed orbiting the star.
Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Technology discovered.
Okay.
Survey complete. Construction complete. Log updated.
Okay. Oh, I see what's going on here. Okay. First of all.
Ships upgraded.
I could use some more defenses here.
Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Initiating communications. Sure. Evading hostiles. Special project complete.
Science Officer Bog has reported a pack with the SP Gleg Lorsch's findings at the Precipient Shrine. They recognized early on that the text in some holographic script is inlaid on the walls, heavily distorted by the layers of translucent lacquer. Initial attempts at unscrambling the text, relying on the raw processing power of the SP Gleg Lorsch's computers to reconstruct the text from plain images, proved fruitless. It was simply too distorted to place in any known lingual family tree. Next, the crew of the SP Gleg Lorsch attempted bombarding the lacquer with light of varying wavelength and intensity, but no beneficial reactions were observed. Bog apparently considered physically separating the lacquer from the inlaid text, but realized that the strength list would undoubtedly have been made misshapen to begin with, only to assume that proper shape when viewed correctly through the lens of the lacquer. Science Officer Bog was about to call the mission a failure when, looking up as they irritably paced along the edges of the circular space, they realized that discrete lines of cohesive text were momentarily forming before their eyes, melting away only to be replaced by new lines. Not long after, they had the ceiling, walls, and floor imaged in a spiral pattern. Text from other shrines should help us piece it all together. Ooh, we found another civilization. Yes.
Survey complete.
Okay.
Construction complete. Log updated. Survey complete.
Program means of a colossal space installation have been found near the MX Singularity. This megastructure appears to have once served as some kind of massive science nexus, although the installation has obviously been managed from millennia, its hull is still recently intact. Do we have any chance of winning that fight? Where are we? I guess.
Construction complete. Construction complete. Special project complete.
The complete doctrine of the gods, for that is what their cover text of we regard as, dwarfing the fairy tales, crafts, comics, revelation, religions were founded as shockingly revelatory as it is revolutionary. Only a little bit of creative interpretation, it's clear that the people of Jackson were meant for great things, guided by the strong hand of a religious leader. Our path is one to godhood, but our past is littered with prophecies unfulfilled and sin born of ignorance. Redemption is ephemeral.
Survey complete.
I'm fiercely frustrated our failure to write down sufficient material to make progress in decoding language used by the Kai aliens. It seems these particular aliens are doing their utmost to prevent their signals from being heard by the wrong sensory hyphae. Thank you.
Special project complete.
The drones and their tireless, endless work of extracting ever-diminishing resources from their local planetoids make for it somewhat dull, but nevertheless informative subject of study. In fact, my network on Jakku Kassandor are the thing or two about maximizing mineral extraction rates while conserving energy. Additionally, we have found that the drones are not completely silent. They emit signal pings, so extremely infrequently, and at a wavelength hard to isolate from background noise. If there's anyone left to receive these pings, maybe a mystery for another time. Two additional generator districts, okay.
Construction complete. Anomaly detected.
Well, the crew disappears. Assorted mountains in the southern hemisphere of Adavatir 1 have been identified as the massive skeletal remains of a single colossal alien life form. The bones of Adavatir 3.4 billion years old, but our scientists have ruled out that Adavatir 1 could have supported life on that scale at any point in the planet's history. Science officer Gloomy has prepared a special research project to delve further into this mystery.
Log updated.
Okay, well, let's just have a ship available to do that.
Survey complete. An alien empire is making contact. Technology discovered. Anomaly detected. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Special project complete.
In 15 stages, the mess is still short of me, so on Advertier 1, Science Officer Glover has concluded that the creature served as some kind of organic starship. Much smaller bones from at least three separate species were found within the larger skeleton. We assume these came from members of the crew. For unknown reasons, this organic starship suffered catastrophic damage and crash landed on Advertier 1. Oh, that's actually recently a story on Drive. Webcomic called Drive by Dave Kellett had an organic spaceship that encountered a problem and catastrophic damage. Anyway, while we cannot begin to understand the biological engineering necessary to grow a starship like this, no, don't do that. The study of these bones alone has substantially advanced our knowledge. What did you just do?
Survey complete.
Oh, sweet.
An alien empire is making contact. Initiating communications.
Yeah.
Anomaly detected. Anomaly detected. Survey complete. Technology discovered. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Anomaly detected. Ships upgraded.
Are we working with these guys?
Survey complete. Log updated.
Roxy Codium started on fire. Oh, these guys are right here. Okay.
Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed.
Oh, there it is. Oh, right. That's the problem.
Anomaly detected. Survey complete. Ships upgraded. An alien empire is making contact. Construction complete. Technology discovered. Log updated. Engaging enemy station. Technology discovered. Construction complete. Construction complete. Technology discovered. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Construction complete. Survey complete. Construction complete. Survey complete. Survey complete. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Construction complete. Construction complete.
Well,
Survey complete. Survey complete. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Construction complete. Construction complete. Survey complete. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Survey complete. Survey complete. Technology discovered. Survey complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Survey complete. Anomaly detected. Technology discovered.
Latest entry readings from Yump show the star pulsating regularly while the crew and SP Glegg Eurodash arrived on site with no evidence to support this data. While most of the crew are in agreement that the anomaly was caused by a sensory malfunction, Science Officer Gloomy discards this theory. Gloomy claims to have discovered similar pulsating energy emission patterns elsewhere, and now appears that something strange is happening to the galaxy stars. They have charted the course to the nearest affected star. Alright, well, that's
long updated.
Let's find out.
Construction complete. Survey complete. Ships upgraded. An alien empire is making contact. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Initiating communications. Technology discovered. Survey complete. Special project complete. Construction complete. Capital project complete. Our presence in the galaxy has not gone by unnoticed. Construction complete. Is making contact. Initiating communications.
Sure.
Construction complete. Initiating communications. An alien empire is making contact. Construction complete. Initiating communications.
On Thursday night, you can catch In Memoriam, the online group. Meets every Thursday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. So, you know, keep an eye out for that. on this channel. That's a Mutants and Masterminds campaign tabletop done over the computer, so everyone's going to be following in. I should go get the rating streams going again soon. Hopefully tomorrow, actually. I do have to go run an errand tomorrow. But hopefully I can schedule things around that. Go to a rating stream, finally get back into writing Telltale's Volume 3. Telltale's Volume 3 is a work in progress. Still kind of doing that. Kind of fell behind a bit with everything going on. My family, three-fifths of my family came down with COVID, and so there was a lot of things that kind of set me busy elsewhere, so I wasn't doing it for a bit. So I'm a little behind schedule on Tall Tales, but I'm hoping to get back into it this week. So keep an eye out on that. In the meantime, you can check out as much of the story as currently exists at talltalesuf.com. That's talltales, talltalesuf.com. It's a urban paranormal fantasy series that I'm writing. Volumes 1 and 2 are out in paperback form on Amazon. But you can kind of catch the first draft of most of the stories that are in the books on the website there for free. It's on hiatus while I get a head start on Volume 3, so it's a great time to catch up on it. New blog post will be going up starting August 1st. So, thank you very much for being here, and you guys have a good night.